Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to more family-friendly gaming with Soap the Great. I am over here on the Hypermind modded server playing some FTB Infinity Evolved. And I'm near a nether portal. You see that right there? I needed to go into the nether real quick. Go grab one of the blocks from my lava generator. And I'm over here on this island like we started off last time. Right here. Because I want to hide some stuff from you. You can see that we've got a little bit of a situation going over here, and I'm gonna share that with you right quick as we move our viewpoint a little bit. So you can see some stuff coming into view. We're going to just do a little, again, progressive revelation here. And recursive networking. It's something with AE. Ballantine's working on that. Let's do there we go. So over here, again, we are working with the idea that this is going to be a castle town. And since the last time we were together, I don't believe I've shown you this. Let's pull up the journey map again, and I'll zoom out a bit. And you can see that I've started a little bit. Well, I've gotten a rough outline. I was trying to do the curves freehand, and that just didn't work so well. Got some skeletons and zombies around somewhere. I guess that's outside of the range of the Magnum Torch. Gotta find those guys. Light up those areas. But anyway, I tried doing the curves freehand and just wasn't working. So instead, what I've done is gone for just these straight edges, and then we will put in the curves later. And that will probably be by the time you get this episode. Again, we're doing bits and pieces here, and it may take a while for me to finish up this episode. You can see I've got a marker over there, and a couple over there and there, and I'll show you the reason why for that. But we're going to come through on the little pathway. You can see right here, this is going to be the entrance, and up here we're going to have a rather imposing structure. I can fly, so we can pop up here. We'll have an imposing guard tower here to look over on this side of the island, because we don't have anything from this section. There's not going to be any way for people to get in over here. We'll have another gate over on that side, but this is going to be the main gate right here. You have to come either through the beach area or that harbor right there. And then what we'll do is just walk on the standard path. Again, I'm trying to work out why I sometimes get dropped frames, and I'll probably have to go through the recording with a fine-tooth comb later, just to make sure. Let's go over to this side. And there is no sprint key in this version of Minecraft. Over here, we've got this structure. I did not want to tear down this beautiful tree, so we've left it. We're going to have a little garden area over here. And then we'll pop back up here, and this is the other section of the wall. Again, farms are going to be out there. And then if we come down here into where the hidey hole is, we've still got the chickens going. And they're producing at a decent rate. Get a decent amount of stuff out of there. And you can see that we've cleaned up some, right? So all the storage is gone. We've got a bunch of books now because I've been using the Disenchanter from I'm not sure which mod, but I've been pulling all of the enchants off the bows and fishing rods that I get out of the fishing setup over there. Right here we've got a sample wall, so since I've got that builder's wand, I can actually play around with this. I've got another tool I need to show you. I can't show its use yet, but it's going to help with building. It's the Resonant Exchanger, and you can use that to switch out blocks almost. Well, it's even better than Creative. So I'm going to be playing around with that, getting this design going. And right now it's just cobblestone. Eventually we'll get the final material. I'm not sure which one I want to use. I'm thinking limestone, because I got plenty of it now, and I'll show you that in right about now. So over here we've got a basic reed farm started, and then I've got my reactor going. You can see I've got a computer on here. I found a program on online. I'll put the link to that in the description box below. And it controls it. It's going to turn off the reactor whenever it gets to 9,000 RF. What is it? KRF? What is this? Oh, I can't see because I've got RF tools in the way. That is... I've got a lot of RF per tick going. Anyway, it automatically turns it off when it gets above 9,000, over 9,000, and it'll turn it back on once it drops below 7,000. So it's working all right. It's all loaded on this disk drive right here as a startup. So whenever I load in, it's going to start that program back up. And we've got plenty of Eulorium because I've been doing some mining. And not standard mining. I'm going to show you something special in just a moment. But right here, you see I've got a little bit of an AE setup going. Got a bunch of disk drives. It looks like the AE system has sorted itself out. It was on yellow for all this, but it looks like it's balanced everything. I guess that's automatic. Right there. Yeah. Yeah. It's automatic. So it figures itself out. I've got the better barrel here in a, what is that, storage bus. So all blaze rods that come into the system are going to go in here. And then this thing can also be used within the AE system. So there'll be two ways of getting blaze rods. You can either get them through the terminal or just come up. Boom, there you go. We'll put that back in. Back here, I've got a bunch of deep storage units. And these are all on, let's see. The dense cable here can have 32 channels per side. And then over here, I've got 8 channels being used. And here's a smart cable. And I've got 8 DSUs on here. They're each holding various things. Marble, coal, limestone. Obsidian is going. Got the obsidian production. We've got over 1 million stone. How in the world do you have that? Soap, I'm going to show you in just a moment. Okay, so there we go. We've got deep storage stuff so it doesn't take up too much space on these disk drives here, or storage cells. And I've got, kind of a ghetto inscriber setup going. Over here, I've moved the machines out, and it looks like that is almost full. Well, there we go. So we can start filling this up. Let's put that's input. So once that thing fills up the capacitor, maybe it'll start filling up the energy cell. And yeah, there we go. So I did have, I'm putting some Eulorium through its paces because I have been quarrying. I got an Ender Quarry and I took that to the Deep Dark. I'm not going to take you there because dimensional travel has a problem right now for me and recording. But if you come in here, we can look at ore in particular. And we've got 30 dense diamond, 945 diamond ore. I got plenty of ores. We have progressed to the point where I don't have to worry about materials much longer. Okay, some of them I still have to do. I need to get automated crafting done with AE especially because we're going to be increasing that a bit. But let's drop down here and I'll show you why we have those pillars all around the base. In fact, let me show you here. I've got them marked out all around here. What's that got to do with anything? Well, if we come down here, it's, we'll wait for everything to load back in. But take a look at that. I got the great idea that I could just use the Ender Quarry to quarry out under the base. And so I've done that. So the bottom 3 subchunks under my entire island are completely quarried out. Let's pull this up, go into caves. So, what do you think about that? That's kind of crazy, isn't it? And then over here, I've got an endothermic pump doing some cleanup. It's not the fastest. I don't know why. And we still got to do that. I've got another one over there somewhere. But how'd you get all that stone? Well, what I did is with the Ender Quarry. Hello, witch. by which we'll come up here. This is the other corner, and I'll show you the Ender Quarry. We've got the World Hole upgrade, the Silk Touch upgrade, Ender Quarry pump upgrade, which doesn't work that well, and the Speed 3 upgrade. And probably the Speed 3 and the pump are not working together very well. But it finished. Okay, so what we're going to have to do is once we clear out all the lava, we will run this thing again and clear out the rest of it, and that should take care of all the rest of these materials. And that might take some time. I wasn't sure if it was causing any lag. Ender quarries are supposed to be pretty lag friendly. But yeah, that's the latest and greatest. I've got plenty of ores, plenty of materials to continue with whatever projects I might need in the future. Now, let me show you some other stuff real quick. Let me get back on the ground because I think flying might have to do. Again, I'm going to be afraid of the dropped frames for a bit, so bear with me if I seem to focus on that too much. But let me show you something. Check out that. Got Wyvern chest plate, Wyvern helm. So we're working through, we're getting some of this Draconic Evolution stuff, and it is doing wonders in terms of the protection level, and we'll eventually get the Wyvern leggings, and maybe eventually the boots, so we can work towards the Awakened boots, and those give you the same ability as the Longfall. But that's kind of where we're at for the moment, and we've been going for about 10 minutes or so. We got some lag going. I can feel it. How's the tick lag? Yeah, we got a little bit of a stutter. Not bad. Not bad. We're on with Tick, Lone Wolf, and Ballantine. Ballantine's working on AE, and Tick and Lone Wolf are just playing to play and doing some crazy stuff. They've progressed through all the mods. But what we're going to do now, I'm going to take a little break, and next time we're together, you might see a little bit more progress. I just wanted to bring you in real quick, show you what was going on. Next time we're together, I should have the final wall in place, the final in terms of the lines for it. And so the materials may not be there, but at least we'll have a little cobble thing outlining what it should look like. So that's what we're going to do next. And yeah, so anyway, I'll see you in a little bit. And we're back over at spawn, and I'm headed over to this little thing over here, and this is from Benito. He's been building something over here with bees, and you see those flying pigs? I logged in. It's an Easter egg for Christmas, and you see we're all decorated up for Christmas. So what Benito has over here is something for bees. He's selling items for doing your own bees if you do so happen to get into that. But he's got this little thing over here, the Bee Lotto. It's a little Christmas thing, and you can click this dropper here and you get a bee. So let's take a look at what I got. The Forest Queen. Now, I'm not into bees so much, but let's see what we can do here. Arid Queen. Skeletal Queen, Gnawing Queen, Emerald Queen. I guess you can get emeralds from that. Rusty Queen, Growing Queen. Yeah, I don't know. There's a lot of stuff here. I've gotten a few hives from the mines and such, but I don't know. We'll have to maybe chat with him about what to do here. But yeah, we've got a few things we could do with our little gift from Benito. But yeah, there we go. Common Queen. But that's about it. Thank you very much, Benito. And we'll have to be back, I guess, for supplies and stuff if we get into that. But yeah, there we go. And Merry Christmas to all. Ladies and gentlemen, we're back. And I've had a little bit more progress. You can see... feeling a little bit of a lag spike here. I'm trying. We've got some other stuff going on. Oh, yeah. Okay. So I'm recording this now after Christmas, and I've got a nice little Christmas present I'm going to be working on here soon, but you don't hear it right now. But it is a new microphone. And the reason you don't hear it right now is because I need a few more things just to get it ready. But yeah, we got a new microphone coming. We're going to be playing with that. Anyway, so what are we doing right now? You can see there's a little bit more progress done. I made these. This is the Draconic leggings, and they make you walk really fast, and I don't really like it. So I put those over there, and instead I've gone with some dark leggings, and I've got those empowered, and it should be fully powered up now. No, it's close to it. It hasn't taken too much damage. So each of these pieces right here, the helm, chest plate, and leggings, they're all RF versions, and so you build up the RF on them, and that's how it takes damage instead of standard durability. You can see we've got a few other machines here. We've got what the slice and spice, slice and splice, and a soul binder, and then a little dimlet researcher. And the reason we have a dimlet researcher is something I'm going to show you right quick. Now, I'm also trying not to move around so much in terms of flying because I've noticed that has a lot to do with potential lag spikes and dropped frames. But I don't have the full, I promised I would have the full wall footprint in. Not quite. I'm still working on it, but you can see I've got a builder's guide here. Let's turn that on. You can see, oh, that's, I need to get like the angel ring. I need to do that instead. You can kind of see the outline that I'm going for there. I'm going to round off on this corner, just round that edge, and then come around like so, bury the wall in the hillside, and then we'll see about what to do on this line. We've got a couple of others. Let me just turn this builder's guide off. I'm going to take care of this not on camera with you because that gets kind of boring. I don't know. Maybe it's not boring, but I mean we're going to be doing streams, so we can take care of some of that type of work on stream. So I'm trying to go slow. It's just there's so much to show you. I really want to show all this stuff to you. But we got to be careful for dropped frames. I'm afraid of those. Okay, so what we got right here is something that's going to happen on the corners. So every corner is going to have a, what is that? Three by three, what, one, two, three. That goes to three by, okay, so it's a 3 by 3. Yeah, so 3 by 3 on each of the corners, and then the main, the in between on the, not corners, but just little outposts along the wall, kind of like you see right here. This is my test area, by the way. It's going to have the 3 by 3 as well. So on the straight sections, like here, we've got a corner, and then we don't have another interesting piece until we get to that corner, so maybe right in here we'll have another little outpost. That's going to be 3 by 3. But let's drop down into the old hidey hole. We're slowly but surely cleaning up. We might have had a little bit of a lag spike there. And I showed you the quarrying that I was doing. Let's come on down here. And I've got it cleaned up. All the lava is cleaned up. We've got what's really weird is in some places, there's a couple spots where we've got these rogue water sources. I don't, they just don't go away. They're there. You put a block in them, then take the block away, and they come back. So I don't know what's going on there. You can see something here in the distance materializing, and you might be able to figure out that it is based on blazes. Okay, so we've got the blaze spawners. I got another one from another fortress, and we're gonna turn down hostile creatures is turned down. Let's just turn down all the volume. And each of those are going into this diamond spike that is enchanted with the Reaper 5 enchantment, which gives me mob souls for doing those stabilized spawners. And we're going to be running a lot of things, a lot of mobs into that spike. And right now in particular, we've got another spawner up top. That is, it's at the top, you can't see it, and I'm not going in there, but it is an Ender.io auto spawner. Just takes RF, and it's got Endermen. So that one is bound to Endermen. I had a bunch of Endermen, or I had this thing loaded, and I was pulling power from my reactor, and I had the world anchor going, and this thing drained a bunch of my Ellurium, and we generated a lot of Endermen. And that gives me Dimlets and Ender Pearls and all sorts of stuff. But right now what we're doing is keeping this generator going. And the generator's feeding this capacitor bank, which is feeding the auto spawner. And it will eventually build up enough RF that it can spawn some Endermen. But I've slowed that down. I went to the personal anchor instead of the world anchor. And I figured out why that doesn't take our Ender Pearls. That's because the config is turned off for Ender Pearls. So it doesn't take any fuel. It just loads the chunks. And that's that. Oh, I don't know if I showed you. This is the crystal grower for, AE2? I'll put that over there. Mostly because that was close to my old hidey hole. And now it's not anymore. I should move it. We'll move it when we get our final area. But I think that's it for the overall progress thus far. What I want to show you is the Dimlets that I've been getting. Okay, so Dimlets are for RF tools, and you can build worlds. It's kind of like Mistcraft, but instead of trying to find books and pages and stuff, you can put these things together, and there's a certain RF cost with them. So I've got this set up where all of the Dimlets go into the researcher, goes into here, this chest, and then a translocator sends anything over into this diamond chest. But we're all full up there too. So I'll be going through and getting rid of some of the ones that I just don't care about, like liquid hollow tears. I don't know what that's about. Molten iron might be good. Red arm, I don't know. We'll have to take a look at those. But once I find ones that I don't want, I'm just going to chuck them into here and see about getting some new ones. So the main thing I'm going for there is a nether quartz or RF tools dimension. And that will give me somewhere easier to get nether quartz than going into the nether. But for now, I need to get some work done on the walls, and then I'll bring you back once we get that footprint done. So I just wanted to bring you in and show you the quarrying effort down under the ground here. All right, see you in just a moment. All right, so what I'm doing is I'm getting ready to make another magnum torch, and I'll just let you know, not all potions of instant health 2 are created equal. See, let's take a look at that one. Won't work. But if we put this one in, it does. Take a look at that. Instant health 2. Instant health 2. The difference here is that the ID is different. This is 373 with data value 16181. You see that there? This one is 373 with data value 8229. They give you the same effect, but this one started off with coming from a witch. This one I brewed from the beginning. So I guess that is the main difference here. So I'm creating another magnum torch because we need another one here on the island. I'm not sure if I mentioned that here or on stream. Let's just wait for the QED to finish its processing here. So I could put another one of those generators. There we go. So we got the other magnum torch, and we're also going to sleep the night away. I've got a little bit of work done, and I'm going to show that off to you right quick. Okay, so you can see some of the progress. What I've gone ahead and done is some of the wall. Let's come over here, and inside of this eucalyptus tree, we're going to hide the magna torch, and that should cover the remainder of the island. We've got three on the island now, and that should keep anything else from spawning ever again. But let's take a look at the footprint. I've almost got it done, not quite. So still remaining is I'm moving this tower right here. And then over here, I haven't quite finalized. This is going to be where the other gate resides. So we've got a gate right here, and we're going to have another gate over here. And then this section right here, the southern section, is still in progress. We should have that done by the next time we're together. But let's just go around real quick, and you can see some of the design decisions. So right now it is all cobble because I've got a resonant exchanger. So whenever I do decide on the block, we can easily switch all of this out. And I've been using the builder's wand and enjoying that immensely. Okay. And over here, this is going to be a guard tower. So we'll have ramparts where we can watch this harbor and this harbor, or this beach area, and also watch any visitors coming in. And I'm not sure if I'm going to continue, have another one of those guard towers copied here. It is rather bulky for the structure, and we're going to have the castle keep right beyond it. So I don't know. We'll see. I'm going to play around with that some off camera, and you'll know once we come back together. We've got a little archway for the gate as well. Nice wide gate, and we can put a little door in here, carpenter's garage door or something. We'll figure that out at a later point. Over here, on each of the corners, we've got little round towers, and that all connects. Over on this section, it was going to be an angled section, but that did not look so good. So angles on there aren't really what we're going for. Right there, I'm just filling in to wherever there is exposed dirt. We're taking cobble all the way down. So the gate's going to be somewhere around here. Ooh, lag spike. Okay. I will hopefully remove that drop frame in hit film in post-processing. But there we go. You can get kind of an idea of how this is going to come together. This is how it's going to look on the outside. A nice imposing wall. Keep getting world save messages there. Nobody else is on with me at the moment. But over here, it's much more imposing if you approach from the water. So that's what I'm going for. And we'll figure out which texture we end up with. But I've got a lot of cobble right now, so it's a good starter block. And we'll get the resonant exchanger in later. Thinking limestone, but I'm not sure. We could end up with the cobblestone texture, but I don't know. Over here, I'm not sold on this quite yet. I want a rounded, kind of like we got for the other corners, but I want it to encompass this whole hill right here. But I don't know, it's not working. So I don't know, I'm going to continue playing with that off camera. And we might have some other design decisions in place when we return. But this video has gotten kind of long, and mostly it's just talking about planning and what we're going to be doing. But now that I've got the footprint in, we'll get to some projects, okay? So next up, we should be working on the castle keep and getting some of the spawners in their final position. You know, that is our goal, is a lot of Draconic Evolution stabilized spawners for most of our mobs, not most of them, just a few, and I've put together a little to-do list here. The Blaze, Witch, Blizz, Cow, so on. The Ghast, we're not going to do a stabilized spawner, we're going to do an Ender IO spawner, because Ghasts fly around and it's harder to harvest them. So we're going to have a little special spot for Ghasts, but everything else should be fine to go in the same area. So there we go. We got a few of the spawners in place, but you can see planning right there. And then over here, we've also got some of our castle to do as well. So there we go. You take a look at these to do items, and if you see any buildings that we need to have, let me know in the comment section down below or on Twitter at MCSoap8. But that's going to be it for this episode on the Hypermine Feed the Beast Infinity Evolve server. And until next time, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you then. Bye-bye.